You see, the three most important directions in which this Modi government is working, I think all three are very harmful for the country. The first is with regard to the economic policies. The Modi government is continuing with greater aggression the policies that were followed by Dr. Manmohan Singh, by which what we mean is that there's a greater emphasis on inviting foreign capital and giving concessions to the Indian corporate sector. Fine, if this is going to increase investment and therefore employment, but the reality in India is that you've opened up all the sectors of the Indian economy to FDI, but where will these investments sell what they produce? The global economy is in a crisis. Our exports have fallen by more than one-third last year. You cannot sell them abroad. In India, the people's purchasing power is constantly declining by the day with this relentless price rise and the administrative hikes in the prices of fuel, etc. So the purchasing power in India is contracting. So where do you sell it in the country? The industry is complaining that there's a three-year inventory of stock that has been piled up. So investment will not lead to employment and therefore to growth. Now, there is an alternative to this. The alternative is, instead of giving these concessions to foreign and Indian capital, collect these taxes, use them for a very heavy dose of public investment to build our much needed infrastructure. That will generate new jobs, employ your youth, and when they start spending their salaries, that will expand our domestic market. And that will be the impetus for future industrialization. So that is what needs to be done. The alternative is pushing more youth into unemployment. The third factor, the second factor, is the relentless pursuit of the communal agenda. The fact that Mr. Modi chose Mathura to be the takeoff point for his one-year celebrations is itself loaded with a very, very heavy communal question. Because after Ayodhya, the targets of the Hindutva forces has been Kashi Vishwanath temple and the temple at Mathura, where in both the places they want to destroy the existing mosques in order to build the temple because of their claim that this is where Krishna was born. The fact that he chose Mathura itself is an indication that in the coming period the communal tensions are bound to rise, and this is going to create not only problems for the religious minorities, for the Republican constitution that we have, but also will slow down our economic growth, because social strife and tensions is what is abhorred by foreign capital, even if that were to succeed their own plan, which won't in any case, as I explained. The third factor is the authoritarian manner in which this government is going about, whether it's the question of center-state relations as seen with the Delhi government, or the letter written separately by 8 Northeast chief ministers saying that you have wound up the planning commission. So what is the mechanism by which the statutory and mandatory 10% development funds of India that should go to the Northeast, how will they go? They sought an appointment to the Prime Minister, which has not yet been given. So center-state relations are worsening. In the Parliament, legislations are passed without reference to parliamentary standing committees, which means without a proper parliamentary scrutiny, which is a very dangerous thing, using there what I've called the tyranny of majority in the Lok Sabha. So these are all very ominous trends towards an authoritarian rule. These three in the coming period will define what sort of India we'll have and how much of hardships will be put, more hardships will be put on the common people of our country.